passage and the previous two verses, verse 1 and 2, Paul had given a charge to Timothy to preach the word in season and out of season. Preach it whether they want to hear it or they don't want to hear it. And what godly people ought to preach is the word. And based on 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 16 and 17, preaching the word means it cannot be a school. God only wants you to be healthy, wealthy, and prosperous kind of message. No, you must preach a word according to 2 Timothy 3:16 and 17, whereby that word is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, and instructions in righteousness. And if anyone is teaching anything else, they are not teaching the gospel. No one called by God is at liberty to preach what they want to preach. And it's hard, listen to me carefully, it's hard to preach if you're not using the Bible. Paul admonished the Bereans in Acts chapter 17, verse 11. He said they were more fat-minded than any other people. And they listened to what their teachers said. But instead, they went back and they searched the scriptures carefully to see what they said were true. Paul provides us insight to our sermon passage in Galatians chapter 1, verse 6 to 8. Let me read those two. It says, I marvel that you are turning away so soon from him who called you in the grace of Christ to a different gospel, which is not another, but there are some who trouble you and want to pervert the gospel of Christ. But even if we are an angel from heaven, preach any other gospel to you than what we have preached to you, let it be accursed. There are some well-renowned pastors who say they don't preach on sin. They don't preach on repentance. They say, look, people already know what they're doing. I don't need to preach on that. I just need to give them some life coach lessons. And then there are others who say that they don't preach on a real place called hell. There are some out now that are saying there is no real place called hell. And then there are others who say there is more than one way to heaven. Surely it can't be just Jesus, right? But since the Bible says in Romans 3:23 that all have sinned, since the Bible says in Romans 6:23 that the wages of sin is death, since the Bible says in John 14 and 6 that Jesus said, I'm the way, the truth, the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. Since the Bible says in Revelation 20 and 15 that anyone not found in the book of life was cast as in the lake of fire. That's hell, y'all. I find it impossible to not include it in the We cannot avoid preaching about the end results of unconfessed and unrepentant sin, because those who live that lifestyle will end up in eternity in hell. Theologian, Dr. E. Epitosa, one of my favorite theologians, he said,
yes, sir,
that which is missing most from the worship experience is expository teaching and preaching. That is teaching and preaching that exposes the truth, the real meaning of the text, with application and illustration of the Word of God. In the end of times, people are not going to tolerate sound doctrine, and they're going to seek out churches and preachers to tell them what they want to hear. They will choose to believe what is in accordance to their own desires, and reject people who believe, who practice, and who teach sound doctrine that leads to spiritual health. In our text, to want one's ears tickled means you desire a gospel that massages you instead of challenges you. You want a gospel that that will entertain rather than edify. We are living right now in the days that Paul is writing about. There is no shortage of false doctrine nor false teachers. So you better separate yourself from the gospel that teaches God wants you to just be happy and live a continuous good life, a life of good times and ease. I say, run! You are being deceived, because 2 Timothy 3:12 says, all who choose to live godly in Christ Jesus shall suffer persecution. A disciple of Jesus is called to deny self, take up his cross, and follow Jesus. We ought to lay down our lives for the purposes of God. Separate yourself from the gospel that focuses on men. And Christ is not glorified, and Christ is not the centerpiece of the attraction of the church. Run from that place. You are being deceived. Separate yourself from the gospel that says that you can be a practicing, unrepentant, homosexual, fornicator, adulterer, or pornographer, and you won't go on to heaven anyway. Run. You are being deceived. Separate yourself from a gospel that says there is no hell. God is a loving God, therefore he can't deliver anybody in hell for eternity. I say, run! You are being deceived. Separate yourself from a gospel that only focuses on the blessings of God, but rarely or never speaks of sin, repentance, and the eternal consequences of sin. Run! You are being deceived. Separate yourself from a gospel that when it's preached, you can walk out of church and not be convicted of the secret sin in your life, the unrepentant sin in your life. And you can come up in here Sunday after Sunday after Sunday and walk out knowing you are living in sin, and there be no convicting power of the Holy Spirit working in you. You are being deceived. God desires for the sinner to confess and repent of sin so that he can forgive and restore the sinner. There's nothing you've done. I don't care if you've been doing it for 50 years. There's nothing you can do that, as long as there's blood running through your veins warmly, as long as you've got a conscience of who you are and you on this side of the Jordan, you can confess and repent, and the Lord That's why we don't meet people over there with the Bible. Because God desires to forgive and to restore. Finally, look at verse 5. It says, but you be watchful in all things, endure afflictions, do the work of an evangelist, fulfill your ministry. According to Jeremiah 29:11, God has a mission and a purpose for all of us. According to Ephesians 2:10, God has prepared work for each one of us. So do not be deceived. No one is called to live a life whereby they are not sharing the gospel. Nobody's called to live a life where you're not making disciples, where you're not reading and studying and obeying the word, where you're not living holy. Nobody's called to stop worshiping God among the fellowship of the believers. Church, regarding our sermon text, the songwriter sums it up like this. He said, in times like these, Brother Madison, say you need to say it. He said, in times like these, you need an anchor. Steve, he said, be very sure. Be very sure that your anchor holds and it grips the solid rock. And the rock that is referring to is Jesus. He is the one. The rock is Jesus. He is the only one. But be very sure that your anchor holds and it grips the solid rock. The only way that we can be protected from the deception of the devil is to be armed